Hello everyone, welcome to the presentation about chromosomal chimeric cells. To the best of my knowledge as of today, chromosomal chimeric cells as described here has not been created. Even if it was created by someone, it is not widely used in therapies. Now we have come to the interesting part. What is the problem we are trying to solve? You may have heard about organ transplants, bone marrow transplants, and other transplants. In these therapies, healthy donor cells, tissues, or organs are transplanted into the patient to replace the corresponding diseased parts. Increasingly, these transplants are based on stem cells. The immune system plays spoiled sport in two ways. In the first case, stem cells from donor may get rejected by the immune system of the patient, or the immune cells derived from the donor stem cells might attack the cells of the patient. This is called the graft versus host disease, or GVHD. Don't we know that the donor cell is supposed to help us? Then why this madness? To answer this question, let me briefly describe the workings of the immune system. Every cell has ID tags, showing literally the name of its owner. These tags are known by the name of antigens, which are nothing but a special kind of protein. These tags are on the outer surface of the cell. The tags displayed by the cells of an individual are all same. This is how the immune system recognizes the self from non-self and avoids attacking our own cells. Now that we have a simplified understanding of the immune system, let me explain the method to this madness. In a transplant, many cells from one person interact with the immune cells belonging to another person. Obviously, the ID tags are different. In this example, you can see that person 1 has squiggly shaped tag and person 2 has straight tag. The immune system has no difficulty in finding the alien cells and killing them. This is nature's elegant technique to defend against bacteria and other microorganisms, which display different kinds of tags on their cell surface, making it easy for our immune system to kill them. Now the same technique hurts us when we want to introduce foreign cells into our bodies. Okay, where do these tags come from? How does one person's cells know that they have to make squiggly tags and another person's cell know that they have to make straight tags? The answer lies deep inside the cell in chromosome 6. The chromosome 6 has many genes called major histocompatibility complex, or MHC genes, which have the blueprint for these proteins. You can think of chromosome 6 as the ID card of a person. So, what's the solution to this problem? Well, there is no easy solution as of today, but we can think of letting the donor cells impersonate the patient's own cells. We know that chromosome 6 is the key to immune system. How about replacing just the chromosome 6 in the donor cell with the chromosome 6 from the patient's cell? In this presentation, I'm calling the resulting cell as chimeric cell, as it contains parts from two different persons. The donor cells start showing the patient's ID tags. The patient's immune system is fooled. Yay! For a moment, let's assume chromosomal chimeric cells are possible. How would this be useful? We can use it for bone marrow transplants, which is used to treat blood cell related diseases like sickle cell anemia. There are embryonic stem cell lines, which are the most potent stem cells. We can think of these embryonic stem cell lines as a limitless source of healthy cells to repair damaged tissue. The problem was that it was not immunocompatible with many people. With chimeric embryonic stem cells, we can make personalized embryonic stem cells for everyone, without having to make any human embryo. There may still be one problem though. Adult chromosome 6 may be different from embryonic stem cell chromosome 6 in terms of epigenetic changes. Possibly we may be able to reprogram the adult chromosome 6 into its embryonic state in the future. We can extend this method of creating chimeric cells to other chromosomes too, and not limit ourselves to chromosome 6. First off, I would say that I'm no cellular biologist. This is just a thought I wanted to share. This is not a peer-reviewed paper. To explain the idea, I have taken the liberty of greatly simplifying the underlying science. The immune cell certainly does not have a knife. I would like to thank Martin J. Cohen, whose video inspired me into this thought. The second video on the genetics of the antigens by Dr. Dolly Tien was very useful in clarifying my understanding about the antigens. Do watch them. Once again, let's say this idea does work. What is the name we can give this baby? The names I could think of are alloautogenic cell, allotogenic cell, personalized cell, selfized cell, selfied cell, chimeric cell, chromosomal chimeric cell. Of all these names, I personally like the name Selfeed Cell because it sounds great. If you think I can contribute to this effort, contact me at trivikram.murali@gmail.com. Thank you.